And welcome back to Let's Play Star Trek. The No Man's Land episode.
Captain's log, Stardate 6236.5. Following our mission to Balkos, the Enterprise is proceeding to Omega Corvus to probe radiation clouds. We are expecting an uneventful mission.
Message from Starfleet Command.
On screen.
This is a code 2 emergency, Captain. Three Federation ships have vanished in the Delphi system within the last month. 3 days ago, we lost contact with the USS Zimbabwe. You are to go to the Delphi system and find out what's happened to our ships. Starfleet out.
Okay. Pretty straightforward so far.
The Delphi system is not far from Romulan space.
Let's not make any accusations without proof, Mrs. Bob.
I make no accusations, Captain. I am simply pointing out relevant information based on the most logical hypothesis available. I would not recommend drawing a definite conclusion from it.
Yeah. In any case, before I forget, let's put shields
raising
up.
Raising shields.
Since we're going near Romulan space. Delphi system.
Delphi system. A ternary star system first charted 30 years ago by the USS Essex. With no habitable planets in the system, the Gamma Delphi sector is known for a high abundance of ion storms.
Looking better and better all the time, isn't it? What was that? That ship?
Delphi system. A
Essex.
Ternary...
USS Essex. Alright, what's the other ship? The, Zimbabwe, right? USS... Zimbabwe.
USS Zimbabwe. Constitution-class starship commissioned Stardate 5621.3, currently under the command of Captain Ulysses Montoya. The Zimbabwe's current non-classified missions include ferrying diplomats between Babel and Vulcan and searching for missing ships in the Delphi sector.
Okay. Well... I pretty much know where this place is. Can I hit that? No, that's... It's this I'm looking for. I'm pretty sure it's right here is Delphi. Let me just take another quick look. Yeah, number 2 on the map. This must be the place. I should have saved. Boom.
Captain, at our current speed of warp 7, I expect to enter the Delphi system in 8 minutes.
Captain,
it's different.
I just started getting the oddest noise on all channels. It sounds like some sort of insect drone.
Let's hear it, Lieutenant.
An object is approaching the Enterprise.
Oh my. What?
Mr. Spock, is that what I think it is?
Sensors indicate that it is an authentic Earth warplane. Circa 1917, belonging to the nation of Germany.
Speak up, Spock.
Its appearance is identical to a Fokker DR-1. Sensors also indicate an immense power source and one life form.
We are being hailed.
This is Baron Trelane von Gothis of the German Air Circus.
Oh, God.
I have identified you as an enemy aircraft. You have 10 seconds to surrender before I blow you out of the sky.
Trelane, but I thought we'd seen the last of you.
He's in... Okay.
Stop playing games, Trelane. Leave my ship alone. We surrender. Trelane, triplanes didn't have radios during the First World War.
Good one.
Trelane, but I thought... Trelane, triplanes didn't have radios during the First World War.
A fourth, option.
Captain Kirk, that is not the way for mortal enemies to greet each other on the field of battle. Of course you hadn't seen the last of me. I am Trelane, the humble Baron of Gothis.
Joy.
Humility is not something that I would associate with you, Trelane. I suppose we're going to get another tantrum from a runaway child with too much power for his own good.
He's a little more grown up this time.
Mortal enemies? When are you going to grow up, Trelane? Humility is not something that I would associate with you, Trelane.
I suppose we're going to get another tantrum from a runaway child with too much mortal enemies. When are you going to grow up, Troy?
I don't know which one to choose. They all pretty much have the same, you know.
Humility is not something that I would associate with you, Trelane.
I guess this is the least antagonizing of all the three.
Oh, this is wonderful! The sarcastic banter of determined foes just before a battle that only one of them will survive.
Put an end to this farce at once, Trelane. You have a way of trying my patience, Trelane. Go home, Trelane, before you get in trouble again.
It's all basically the same aspect, the same attitude.
Didn't your parents punish you enough, Trelane? Put an end to this farce at once, Trelane.
I'm not sure if it makes any difference which one I choose. I'm just glad my shield is still up. I wish I had actually saved the games. If I die, I'll have to play through the end of the last session again, the last episode. Put an end.
You have a way of trying my patience, Trelane. Go home, Trelane. Didn't your parents put an end to this farce at once, Trelane?
I guess this one.
If you insist.
Sensors indicate he is closing on us. I can extrapolate that he intends to fire on us.
Raise shields, evasive maneuvers.
Raising shields.
Shields are already up. Weapons?
Arming weapons.
Okay, hold on. Can I tab out and just save? Hold on a moment.
Save new game.
Yeah, new game. Should we fire on him? Well, we are damaged. I guess we're firing on him. Isn't he, like, omnipotent, kind of? He wants to play. Let's play. We've yet to hit the guy. Here we go. This is ridiculous.
Aye, sir.
He's like, we're not moving at all. Here we go. So how hard is this gonna be? Wait.
Nice, sir.
That was weird. Scotty is repairing the engines very quickly. I remember it being a lot. Maybe that's what makes the battles easier, because I'm not choosing hard difficulty or something.
Damage control standing by, sir. Damage control standing by, sir.
Standing by?
The weapons are offline. The shields are falling. The weapons are offline.
Well, no.
By, sir.
All our weapons are offline.
Damage control standing by, sir.
Why is he staying standing by? Say aye, sir. Let me know that you're, you know, fixing it. Well, he fixed it, I guess. I'm not used to him saying that. Damage control is standing by. We need to actually hit the frickin' thing. Should be good. We're like completely fine. We can get the shields back up.
Thank you.
How am I not hitting him?
Disarming weapons.
No, no. Weapons. Not that. I want target analysis. Wait, we're so close again. He's all red. How can we tell he's damaged? This could be a lengthy battle, guys. We're doing okay, it's just I can't get him on my screen, and we're already up to like warp 9 or whatever. Impulse speed 9. And he just zooms past us anyway. Thank you. Sorry guys, this is a little boring. I'm actually a little bored myself. Thing is, if this is acting like a regular ship, it's being repaired as it's evading us, so he's, you know, always going to be at full strength, unless we get a whole bunch of blasts in a row, and alright, let's go the opposite way. Not hitting us. All right, let's head up away from him. Should be right here, up there.
Engine repaired, Captain.
Thank you. Like way off here. It's too damn fast. How do we end this? How does this get over? Ooh, I hit him. That was not bad. I mean, mean, I'm not sure. Where is he? It looks like the wheel might be damaged, or it's red already. I can't even tell. He looks undamaged.
Target analysis off.
Aye, sir.
Trying to do something.
Alien frequencies open.
Yeah. How are we gonna win this? Isn't he basically omnipotent? Are we supposed to lose it? Where are you? Oh, right there. So he didn't cause any damage to us. Well, a little to the shields and the forward saucer section, but. Damn it. I can't tell.
Target analysis off.
Engine repair, Captain. Aye, sir.
We'll never hit him with those photon torpedoes. Not unless he's going right at us. Sensors again. This is gonna be the whole episode, I'm sorry guys. I might just leave a link to skip. Yes, yes. We might be supposed to lose and then he takes mercy on us, something like that. Wouldn't be surprised, he's tricky. Over here. Thank you. I think if we hit lock.
Weapons are locked.
Are weapons still locked? They're still missing. Oh, there we go. The hull. that. Are we still locked? That's working. Hey, we're okay again. Shields.
Ice on it.
Hey, hey.
Don't celebrate too soon, Mr. Chekhov. Trelane is like a bad penny. He keeps turning up where he's not wanted.
The triplane has reformed.
It is hailing us again, sir.
Oh my.
You cheated! You cheated!
Weapons locked.
I beat you fair and square, Trelane. Now leave my ship alone.
Oh, these are choices. Okay,
Don't be such a poor loser, Trelane. Your quarrel is with me, Trelane, not my ship. If you're going to punish anyone, punish me.
Oh, he'll do it too, though.
I beat you fair and square, Trelane. Now leave my ship alone.
This one.
No, Kirk, you cheated! And you're going to have to be punished.
No.
Your insolent ship will have to be punished as well.
Negative.
But only you will bear the full brunt of my revenge.
Oh, goody.
Leave my ship out of this, Trelane.
Are you trying to give orders to the Baron of Gothos, Kirk?
Baron of Gothos?
You should go to my dungeon for that. You and a few others of my choosing.
It's all right. We started out in a prison cell with this...
We have been
game?
Unconscious for a considerable length of time, Captain. This is Lieutenant Commander Ellis, First Officer and Security Chief of the USS Zimbabwe.
Hello, Mr. Ellis. Where is your captain?
He was in sick bay at the time that triplane attacked us. I don't know what's going on.
What is going on, Commander, is a gentleman named Trelane. An immature child of a race with vast powers. Somehow he acquired an unhealthy fascination with human military history. Last time we encountered him, he had an interest in the Napoleonic era.
It would appear, Captain, that his awareness of human history has advanced to the level of your First World War.
If it advances any further.
Not only do we need to escape this place, but we need to find a way to discourage Trelane's interest in war once and for all.
How did you escape from him last time, Captain?
His parents appeared and punished him. I doubt that we can rely on such an intervention a second time.
So, we've got our red shirt back. My hair is annoying the hell out of me in conjunction with my headphones. Let us look at our crew.
James T. Kirk, who wonders how he's going to defeat Trelane this time.
We gotta beat him at his own game. Battle of wits kind of thing.
Mr. Spock finds this situation fascinating.
Yeah, I hear a dog. Huh.
Dr. Leonard McCoy, who wonders what is really going on.
And it's been about time since we had a red shirt.
Lieutenant Commander Ellis is frowning. This sort of stuff always seems to happen to the Enterprise.
Yeah, really. Lieutenant Commander, you're wearing a red shirt, thus you are a red shirt.
There are many bundles of sticks piled against the wall.
I thought that was hay. This is hay.
Straw. Not the sort of bedding that Starfleet officers are used to. Rather damp, too.
Oh, that would be because of the leak.
There are many bundles of sticks. A small barrel rests against the wall. It is empty.
Boxes?
A crate. It is labeled Schnapps. It is unopened.
Oh yeah, let's dig into that.
A crate. It... A crate.
These are all Schnapps?
A crate. A light bulb, triggered by a chain, is suspended above the center of the room. The chain is broken. A light bulb.
Oh, triggered by a chain?
The walls of this room look very sturdy. The floor is not very clean, especially when compared to a well-run starship.
Yeah, I guess these guys got spoiled.
The only door in this room, it is locked. The only door in this... The only door in this room... The walls of this room... The walls of this...
That's the ceiling.
Anyone have any ideas about how to get out of here?
Look for another breach in the wall's integrity.
Fascinating. This appears to be an Earth domicile, late 19th or early 20th century. At least nobody's sick.
Okay, take us out of here.
Beam us up, Scotty. Speaking of which, I don't suppose we can contact the Enterprise.
The communicators are functioning, Captain. If there were other Federation personnel on this planet, we would be able to communicate with them.
Provided their communicators haven't been confiscated, or the persons are in any physical condition to answer.
I did not wish to state the obvious, Doctor.
Ha!
Ha! Now, the funny thing is, how far away are we from the Enterprise? How far away are we from where we just were? Rocks?
The floor is not there. The floor is not...
Sometimes you could pick up rocks, and I didn't know that.
The floor is not...
Okay, never mind then.
You pick up a stick.
A stick! Goody.
The barrel's full of holes, Captain. It's useless.
Maybe use it to bash stuff.
Now is not the time to go to sleep.
Haha. How about have some snaps?
The crates are nailed shut. You are unable to open them.
Spock, do you wish to analyze things?
These sticks were taken from a pine tree. Given their shape, I would speculate that they are used for kindling. A wooden barrel containing nothing. The tricorder detects no unusual properties.
Captain?
Ordinary straw, Captain. The tricorder detects no unusual properties.
And how good is this schnapps?
It would appear to be an ordinary crate, Captain.
Of course it's a crate. It looks like a crate, feels like a crate. What else could it be?
Doctor, we are dealing with an entity who is capable of sustaining an artificial atmosphere on a planet, and then flying that planet around the universe like a starship.
Spock's right, Bones. When we're dealing with Trelane, we need all the information that we can get. Something that looks trivial might be the key to defeating him and saving the Enterprise.
And the Zimbabwe.
Well, we got a stick.
This light bulb is an anachronism. Although its light output is typical of period lighting sources, it is far more energy efficient and encased in shatterproof glass.
Trelane was never very good at getting the fine details right.
A correct observation, Doctor.
For all his power, he can be outwitted, I think. What about this stick?
These sticks were taken from local fir trees. They seem rather brittle.
Oh, brittle? Well, I was hoping maybe we could use it to pick this lock.
The chain is broken. It is obvious that you cannot turn it off.
It's probably a good idea if we keep our distance, Captain.
Why? I want to give you a big huggy.
I don't think you need a doctor right now, Jim.
Captain, I do not require your assistance at the present time.
Funny. I bet you McCoy will go to sleep.
Now is not the time to go to sleep.
Oh, come on.
You already have a stick. You already have a stick.
I'll do it.
Oh, you can open this one? Oh, cool.
The crate is open. It is
I'll do
full
it.
Of bottles of Himmrick Schnapps. The date on the bottle says 1913.
Kirk, you lush you.
There are several bottles of schnapps here.
And what do we do with schnapps? We take it.
You have taken several bottles of schnapps.
We are ready for a good party in here. All we need is some music. Can you play music with your tricorder, Spock? We got a big old party time. Okay, maybe not.
The finest schnapps that money can buy, or so you'd like to imagine.
Let us combine the schnapps with the stick.
That's no way to treat a good bottle of schnapps.
Let us take the schnapps and give it the bones.
Not as good as steel magnolia. Perhaps later. You carry it, Jim.
Oh boy, I'll carry it.
Vulcans do not drink.
He needs to loosen his Vulcan ears a little.
I have observed on numerous occasions, Doctor, where you have regretted your indulgence in alcoholic beverages.
Hmm. While I'm on duty? Are you serious?
Oh, come on. Live a little. Break it against the door. You gonna break it against the door?
Keep it down, Schweinhund!
Huh. So, there's a guard out there.
Keep it down, Schweinhund!
Schweinhund. So we're in Germany, apparently. Can we speak to him through this?
You get no response.
Hmm. Well,
The door is securely locked, Captain. I am unable to open it.
Does anyone have a safety pin?
A what? I don't think so.
I have a stick. But I was told to keep it down, Schweinhund. Let this leak. We can't really see where it's coming from.
The walls of this room look very sturdy. The chain is broken.
I see no need for that, Captain. I see no need for that, Captain.
How's your luck?
Lieutenant Commander Ellis is showing heightened levels of stress.
How about Ellis? Mess with the door.
This shouldn't be too much of a problem. It's a very primitive lock.
Really?
Damn. I'm afraid it is a problem.
Huh. Would you like the stick?
Is this how you treat security officers on the Enterprise?
I'm not hitting with the stick. I'm trying to give it to you.
The logic of this action escapes me, Captain.
Well, we have our weapons and stuff.
It's not firing.
The phasers have been completely drained of energy.
Courtesy of our charming host, no doubt.
No doubt. Well, gentlemen, if we're going to beat Trelane, we'll have to beat him on his own terms.
What if we replenish the energy with the light?
The phasers are still completely drained. Attempting to use them would be a wasted effort.
What else do we have? Not much.
The walls of this room look very sturdy. A crate. It is labeled schnapps. There are several bottles.
What do we do with the schnapps? What do we do with the twig? I tried to pick the lock with that.
Keep it down, Schweinhund.
Instead, I'm like stuffing it through the hole.
The only door in this room, it is locked. The walls of this room look very sturdy.
There is nothing unusual about the door. I am conducting a sensor sweep of the area. We appear to be about 15 meters underground. There's a single human life force stationary, approximately 6 meters from the door, and about 6 life forms in our immediate vicinity on the surface.
Okay. Well, now that you know he's there, can we talk to him now?
You get no response. You get no response.
Let's try this now.
Keep it down, Schweinhund!
No effect.
The phasers are still completely... The phasers are still completely dry. A stick made from a dead pine tree.
Well, that was a freaking stick, man. And alcohol.
This registers on my tricorder as schnapps, an alcoholic beverage.
We know what schnapps is, Spock.
My apologies, Doctor.
I told him to. Okay. I told him to analyze it. What if we pour the alcohol?
Kirk, we're going to need all of our wits if we want to survive. Put the alcohol away.
Are you planning to christen it, Jim?
We're allowed to pour it here, though. Thanks, guys.
You cover the straw with schnapps.
Now what do we do?
Straw. Not the sort of bedding that...
I covered the straw with schnapps.
Ordinary straw, Captain.
Do I now get the straw?
I don't think we'll need it, and we could probably get it somewhere else if we did. No effect.
The phasers are still...
Yes. On stun, maybe?
No effect.
The phasers are...
We could start a fire. Maybe we just... get this?
You cannot reach the light bulb.
Why not? It's shoulder length with Lieutenant What's-His-Name.
The chain is broken.
I don't see any medical emergencies, Jim.
Trying to start a fire here.
Captain, I believe we need all the light we can get. It is not an advisable course of action.
Maybe if I scrape this...
Put the stick away, Jim.
I'm trying to start a fire.
Put the stick away, Jim.
If I scrape the stick against the rock, I might cause a spark. Oh, wait, what am I doing now? Oh, that's what I did. Cool. Haha.
What's going on here?
We should leave this building immediately. The proximity of this fire to a large concentration of alcohol puts us at considerable risk.
All right, Spock. Do your thing. Yay.
I thought that was my job.
You don't know the Vulcan nerve pinch, death grip, whatever you...
This seems pointless.
Analyze the fire. Fire spreading.
The tricorder detects nothing unusual.
Okay, we drag him out then.
No effect.
Because he'll die and stuff. We're gonna lose demerits. I don't care if he dies, we'll just lose demerits.
We're supposed to use this on people.
That is a person.
We're supposed to use this on people.
That's not a person?
This seems pointless.
Alright, let's get the hell out. Nope. Okay.
Load a previously saved game.
Oh my god, did I save? Oh crap. Alright guys, see you in the next episode. Thanks for watching. See you next time and enduring for strong.